Good day. As I had some free time on my hands during the winter holidays, I decided to run a test between the Canon R6 and the R6 Mark II and see how do the sensors compare when it comes to noise, latitude, and if there's any difference in the colors they produce. First, let's have a look at the colors of both cameras and if they can be used on a shoot together as Cam A and Cam B. By the way, the clips with the blue flag in the corner indicate that the footage was taken with Canon R6 Mark II, and the clips without the blue mark were taken with Canon R6. I used this white card to set up custom white balance on both cameras. Then, when I brought the footage to my DaVinci Resolve, I applied color space transform and added a simple curve just to bring the footage back to life. So this is clip taken with Canon R6 Mark II, and this is the clip taken with Canon R6. So when we apply the grade from R6 Mark II to Canon R6, you can see that the colors match pretty well. Let's make it bigger. And I didn't even use the color checker tool to match the footage on both cameras. Just simple copy and paste of the grade, and it already looks great. Now, let's check the latitude of both cameras and see what happens when we underexpose the footage and then raise the exposure. I will not be doing any other adjustments, so we can see how the footage behaves when it comes to color shifts and noise. By the way, in camera noise reduction was turned off on both cameras. With one stop of underexposure, footage of both cameras have a similar color and there isn't really much noise. With two stops of underexposure, there is a slight color shift and the noise is quite visible. The noise pattern is similar in both cameras. When the footage is underexposed by three stops, we see a clear color shift in both cases. The R6 Mark II shifts towards magenta and the R6 towards green. The noise pattern is similar in both. Four stops of underexposure brings even stronger color shifts and uglier noise. Five and six stops of underexposure aren't usable, but let's have a look just for fun. Now, let's see what happens when we overexpose the footage. Just to remind you, both cameras were set to C-Log 3, which gives us more room in the highlights than in the shadows. So the footage is recoverable up to about four stops of overexposure and falls apart at five stops on both cameras. Just have a look at the tomato. In conclusion, the latitude and colors of both sensors are very similar. None of them have a clear advantage as of now. It might, however, change when the R6 Mark II gets access to ProRes RAW, which I will test again as soon as it is released. So please subscribe and ring the bell so you get notified when the test is ready. Thank you for watching.